Yeah. Welcome back, everybody. I thought I'd do a little bit of a longer video. It's not going to be too much longer. I was running short on film for last week, or what I wanted to film. So that's the reason there's not been a video, because why would I want to post something short if it's not going to be very quality? So let me get some more quality stuff and get some more stuff going for you. I'm going to insert some stuff with Grace here. Meaning you guys are gonna get to see the new tune. I did take her to a wash yesterday, but we live on a dirt road, dirt driveway, doesn't do me much good. So we do have the burble tune working. Got some compliments on our lighting. We've got our team AMR minus the A on this side. Mafia tuned both sides, diode dynamics. All the good stuff, JLT, we've got all of this. So if anyone else wants to sponsor me, I have no problems putting stickers on my car, trust me. So how about Texas Speed, some new headers maybe? Discounted, maybe. Sponsor, who knows? Really love Texas Speed headers, and I think they would be an amazing addition to this car. Antimatter blue, you can really see the blue showing right now in the sun. We got our Toyo R888Rs, our Michelin PS Sport Pilot Sport 4S's up front. We got our Daily Exotics Colorado stickers. Who thinks we should do custom 5.0 badge and a GT badge on the back as well as the custom pony on the front? Who thinks, what do you guys think about that? I'm thinking maybe a blue, who knows, maybe something like that. We got our blue steering wheel, so why not? But we might do something a little bit more cool than that. We got our tire shine. Oops. We got our tire shine about to go on. But before the tire shine, let me show you guys something else really quickly. So I don't believe I have shown you guys this just yet. So we're going to do this. We're going to throw some tire shine on. Keep our tires looking really nice. Nice, slick, black tires. Oh yeah, I forgot to tell you guys, we got our intake in. Yes, we got our big old JLT intake all hooked up. She's looking good, no more engine cover. Thinking of maybe a Whipple on there, who knows? I've been really struggling financially right now, so I'm doing everything I can for you guys with what I got. We got our Mishimoto coolant reservoir, our auto LED tech colored headlights, but again, colored pony, colored badges, all that stuff. I think that'd be really cool. All our diode dynamics engine bay lighting. Like I said, I got no problem. I have to get some Mishimoto stickers. I haven't actually put them on yet. We also have Rev Auto. I got to get a new Rev Auto for cleaning supply sticker. We got more diode dynamics as well as our Nationwide Productions, our German Nationwide Productions limited matte collection, car sponsors. Don't forget to check the Instagram out, guys. Got some quality content there as well. Definitely go check my reels out. Trust me, those things are fire. Redline tuning has to do with our hydraulic hood struts up front. Obviously, we already discussed JLT. Oh, darn, I didn't even notice I lost my Gorilla Car Care sticker, and that was a limited one for Halloween. So we'll get a new Gorilla Car Care. By the way, for Gorilla Car Care, there's a discount code down in the description down below. So make sure you guys go check that out. We got MBRP and American Muscle, where I buy a lot of parts from. Thinking we're going to get some new wheels here soon. Well, not too soon, but we are going to get some more. But let's go ahead and throw on some tire shine. Let that soak in. And like I said, JLT, I'll get a little bit of a startup here for you guys soon, and then I'll try and get some revs in so you guys can hear that, because I'm sure it sounds amazing. I can actually hear it taking in the air while driving, which I think is super, super cool. But I think what would be really even more cool would be definitely getting a Whipple on there. Now, my question, I know they do a blue, but it's not like this blue. It's like more like grabber blue. What do you guys think about getting a grabber or getting a either that or getting color matched one? And yes, I'm aware all those micro scratches, trust me. Working on, first off, I still got to get this fixed, this bumper. Once that bumper is fixed, which should be about 1500, probably maybe upwards closer to 2. I don't know if it's going to be 2000, but once we get that fixed, we're going to get her paint corrected and ceramic coated, as well as some tint all at the same time. So yes, indeed, that does mean, now I got to let this sit for 15 minutes. I think that's what it says, right? Anyone else? Tire Shine always loved that stuff. Yep, so, it's only 5 minutes. Before driving, and I forgot to shake it. Oh well, I'm gonna keep this in the car. It's done through turtle wax. I'm gonna be coming out with a ceramic coating as well as another line here of stuff. So let's get this close up. Those red line hood struts. But yes, we are gonna be getting tint, ceramic coating, 5% ceramic tint. Ceramic coating, paint correction, all done at the same time. Let these sit for about 5 minutes as I start dropping stuff off my car, courtesy of Colorado weather and wind. Yeah, that ain't looking good. Get that all cleaned off here. But yeah, let's set this back up here. Do this for you guys. You guys are going to get to hear the startup. No, she does not really pop, but I do definitely need to get headers, and I know that for a fact. Last time, this tune messed my headers up in the manual. So, Grace 1.0, this is Grace 2.0. So, we've got to get a few more stickers done for everything we've done on her. But, yeah, obviously, my inside window, I got to get that cleaned. I had peaches in the car the other day, and those are all nose prints. It is so hard to keep this car clean. I wish it was easier. We are gonna make it. We're gonna make sure she's cleaned up and everything. But we got a lot still to do. But we're getting there. And once we get some things done here, like I said, we've still got a lot to do that I want to do at least. I'm kind of done modding her for now. We're gonna save up. The main focus right now, like I said, for me personally, is get the bumper fixed to start with. Get our bumper fixed is next. Get it tinted, ceramic coated, paint corrected, all that good stuff. Then right here, you guys can see, I want the 2018 lights. These are 15 through 17, so they don't have the little indent. So we got to get those as well. And then last but not least, I have a little bit more of a surprise for you guys that I want to do. I don't know if it's gonna work, but we're definitely gonna give it a shot. So it has to do with the exhaust, and it is not headers, but you guys will get to find that out once I actually do it. We are gonna go Ford Performance rear seat delete. The official rear seat delete coming out of, like the 350Rs and 500 track packs. Stuff like that, or carbon package, rather. Now, inside, I don't like this dash too much, so I think we're going carbon dash. What do you guys think? Carbon dashboard, just like in the carbon package. Yeah, I agree. We're gonna throw our lights on, and then let's go ahead and get a cold start. It's been about probably about 14 hours. I love these lights, they are so cool. Huge shout out to Auto LED Tech. Those are just nothing but awesome. But now let's go ahead and get you guys a cold start, and then I'll let you guys see the burble too. So burble on the road. Let's go ahead and do this right here. Ready? Cold start in 3, 2, 1. Thank you. American Muscle and MP Concepts. So as for MP Concepts, for those of you who are unaware, MP Concepts is the reverse light that I have on there. It is aftermarket, for those of you who are not aware of that. Man, that was quite a cold start. Really shook the car. I wasn't expecting that. But yeah, so MP Concepts did my reverse light there. Not the reverse light. Reverse light, and it doubles as a running / brake light. But I'm gonna see if you guys can hear the intake sound at all. You kind of can, yes. That mechanical sound, that's due to the intake. I'm gonna see if I can get her to pop. If not, you guys are gonna hear her pop on the way out the driveway. So there you go. So there was a little bit. Now before neighbors start, you know, complaining, I'm gonna head out. But yeah. So I'll let you guys hear it as we back out. We've got some things, got possibly an interview to do. Gonna go get some lunch. Got our Fiero out. Motorhome is gone. I will post a garage update. I know you guys have seen how terrible that garage looks. Not for much longer. You guys are gonna get to see it really cleaned out, and I'm making it look really cool. Doing a lot of work to it, but let's go ahead and head out. That was a single pop. You'll hear it more. I'm trying to be generous because we've got our horses over here from the neighbor horses. We got their cows right there and they don't like the tune that much. So yeah, let me get over here. I don't know if it's picking up on camera. There is a little bit of a high pitch noise. That is actually coming from the intake, but we'll get more of an exterior intake a little bit later. But yeah, here. Okay, so I'll get it right up here for you. SCT Tommy gun, guys. So that's how it sounds. For those of you who are not here and joining the channel back when I had Grace 1.0 in manual form, that's how it sounds. Pretty freaking cool. Super obnoxious, yes, indeed. Anyways, I'll get back with you guys a little later, but we are currently heading for lunch, and then we'll go from there. So I'll see you guys in just a bit. Peace for now. What's good, everyone? So welcome back. I do apologize. This video was not up on Wednesday. However, I got a little sidetracked. I have some more things going on. Today is now Saturday, so I did skip a week. I am working on getting the video completely compiled together over the last couple weeks. On Tuesday, it was actually my birthday, so that is a good partial reason as to why I was not filming or uploading. We do have a burble tune, as I think we already know about that, so I think you guys have already seen that. We haven't done too much more to the car, but we're working on getting some work going so that we can start pushing this car along. So we're working on that. So this is just kind of letting you guys know why I didn't upload. I will try not to make the video too long. I don't know where it was sitting prior to this clip. So I'm just going to go ahead and go from here. I maybe will add another clip, a couple other things. But make sure you guys go down into the description down below. Check out the merch, dailyexoticscolorado.com. And then also go ahead and make sure you go check the Instagram out. Posting a lot of reels lately for you guys. So I'm hoping you guys are enjoying. I know everyone else is enjoying. So I'm hoping some of you guys that are subscribed are checking that out as well. I'm posting on there a lot. I know my consistency is not super amazing yet. I am working on that. So every Wednesday I'm still going to be posting. I'm just having some problems with that. Been a little bit slow with that. So I will be starting to upload a lot more every single Wednesday, and then I'm gonna make a little bit change to the schedule of merch. So yes, I am wearing merch right now, but merch is only gonna be coming out every, I don't know, I'm gonna say I'm probably gonna do it at least once every couple of months. I'm not for sure on the schedule just yet, but let me know down in the comments down below what you guys think you would want to see the merch levels come. As you can see, car's a little bit of a mess. We're gonna go get her cleaned up. We took the rear seats out. We are gonna get her tuned a little bit differently, throw some headers in now, tint, but I have a schedule for that. It's gonna be over the course of the next year. So there are gonna be a lot of videos where it's just gonna be kind of doing some other stuff not directly related to Grace the Mustang here. So I do have another great plan coming for another car. That's gonna probably replace Grace afterwards. We gotta get her aligned. But part of the thing I wanna do for you guys, this is quick, it's fun. Kinda. I know it's gonna be faster, but who doesn't like being able to put their right hand on this, shift manually, use that third pedal? Yeah, I know I do. I miss my manual. Unfortunately, there's not a lot I can do right now, but we are gonna be getting another manual. I won't say which car yet, because I don't know just yet, but I do have a pretty, I have quite a idea on what I wanna do. It's not exactly quite where I want, exactly what I want, but it's going to be kind of similar to this. There is going to be some weight reduction. I will put out, it's not going to have rear seats, so if that gives you guys any hint, not that this really has seats anyways, I'm in and out with them for weight. So yeah, we're going to go down that road. There should be some major updates. Bumper should be fixed, some tint coming, all that good stuff coming about April of next year. If I can get it done sooner, I will, but I'm a little bit behind on some other things, and I got a lot of other stuff going on with family and stuff, so I've got to, you know, I got to take care of family and do my stuff there, make sure I'm taking care of myself, but I'm also bettering that, so I'm still going to try and be as consistent as possible. Like I said, I try not to bring my problems here to the channel. I know that's been a little bit of an issue in the past, so I'm trying to, you know, keep that out of the way now. Be a little bit more professional with you guys, so, but we're still gonna have our fun, you know, cars are fun, so might as well have fun. We'll get some meets going. Meets are, they're still happening around here in Colorado. We've barely had any snow so far, which is unusual. In fact, tomorrow would technically be a record. I don't know if Denver got snow yesterday. I know we got snow a couple days ago in Parker. So yeah, we'll get that done, and then I'll see you guys a little bit later. And this video is going up on Wednesday, or possibly it might go up a little sooner, and then I'll put up another video Wednesday, but I don't want to, you know, suffer quality just to get a video drop. So if I have to, I'll spend a little extra time. And as you can see, here's my love over here. So say hi.
Hi.
So yeah. So we're gonna go do our stuff now, and I'll see you guys in a bit. Peace. What is good, everyone? So, news. Yes, the hair is lighter. It's been dyed again, or bleached rather. So it's a little bit lighter now. Number two. Tomorrow I'm gonna get some filming for you guys. We're gonna be going down, and I got some decorations right here in the back. We're gonna be decorating the car up, doing this, I think I said tomorrow. Sunday we're gonna be doing it. It's a little cruise we'll be doing. Everyone's got their cars stretched up, a little group here in Parker. And then I have to take it easy, cause now I've been forced to get headers. Now let me explain why. Yeah, check engine light, catalyst. So the Burbleton has destroyed my cats. 13,000 miles into the car. We've only had the tune for about a week. About 2 weeks now. So we are gonna be getting that done. We are ordering headers. The local shop that I'm gonna get them tuned requires headers though, because Colorado is now trying to pass California emissions. I don't have to do emissions until 2021, so there is a very good chance I might see if I can find another shop and do the catless ones, because they are, make this a proper straight pipe. The car is not due for emissions till 2027. Only issue is I will not have the car by then. but we're gonna kind of see what we can do from there. And the fact that catless is cheaper, so I'm gonna see if we can do some catless stuff. My headers have basically blown up inside, so they're melting down. There's noise. No, I don't have a sound to, but you should be able to hear it. I don't know if it'll be audible on camera, but... there's kind of that rattling. Yeah, that rattling is coming from inside the cats. It's not meant to sound that way, and it did not sound that way. Bumper is still not fixed. We're working on that. We're getting it paid. We are keeping her for a while. Being sure getting her paid off. Obviously rear seat's back in. I just need the space. This is my daily car, so I don't have a lot of choice. We are getting a car with only two seats next, so that is a big kind of surprise. So you'll get to see that coming in next year. It's not gonna have rear seats at all. It's gonna be way faster. It'll be lighter than this. So if that gives you guys any hints, go ahead and put your guesses down in the comments. Doesn't mean I'm telling you what, but definitely check the comments. Let me know what you guys think I am buying next to replace good old Mustang. Four Mustangs later, we have finally, I've had a little bit of everything I've wanted between every single one. It's just taken me four Mustangs because I kind of kept upgrading and switching. The only thing that kind of sucks for me on this one is I'm building it and it's got every performance thing I've wanted, minus maybe a supercharger, but the it's auto, which I kind of don't like, but it's all right. It's all right. Next car is going to be a manual. It's going to be lighter and faster. That's all I'm going to give you guys for now, but that one will be getting modded as well. It's getting tuned. E85 for sure on that one. Full exhaust, headers, intake, and that's where we're leaving it for a while because we'll be getting close to four-figure horsepower. That car will be getting kept up until and then I'm going to get me the next car, which will start hitting supercar levels. So that's my goals. So just let you guys know the goals for the channel. So yeah, cats are melted, have not determined how bad yet. I do want to see if I can find a cutout version where you can just cut in bolts, cut in clamp, or cut in weld. One of the two where you can cut and put in a straight piece. If anybody knows somebody in Colorado that does that, please comment that down below. Or if you guys know anybody who actually does cats or can take them out or the... you know, installs catless headers in Colorado, let me know of that as well. And if you guys know someplace that actually sells something that is a cat delete, because I haven't been able to find them. I know that that's getting harder to find anyways, because you're not supposed to. But please let me know if you guys know any place that is willing to do that or the parts for it. If not, I will do catless headers if I can find a shop that will do it. If you guys know a shop that will accept catless headers here in Colorado, let me know down in the comments if you guys know anyone. But yeah, so we've got those going. I know the driver's side is far worse. The passenger side is going as well. It's not as bad, to my knowledge at least. But yeah, so we're probably not doing any wheels. We're kind of done with cosmetic, being I have no choice really but to do headers. We're doing the headers, and then I'm kind of laying off on everything because I want to get that bumper fixed so it'll be good enough to, you know, trade in for the next vehicle. And I'm going to get the steering wheel done better because, as you guys can see, you know, it's not on right. And I want to try and see if I can get somebody to fix it so we don't have an airbag light. I might see if Ford is willing to mess with it a little bit, see if they can get it on a little better and do that. I don't know if they will, so I may have to see if anyone knows anybody in Colorado that does carbon fiber, like steering wheels or does steering wheels specific, please let me know down in the comments on that as well. So yeah, that's kind of the goals for now. We're getting the bumper fixed. We may get some tint going. And we'll kind of go from there. I don't know if tint's gonna happen yet. My main thing is getting it retuned, getting the headers in, and getting the bumper fixed, which should be happening before May of next year at the latest. So that's where we're going from. Say hi.
Hi.
So we're going from there. So cats are melted for now though.
but we'll go from there, and then I'll see you guys once we get those ordered. There will be a part two, so keep an eye out for that. Make sure you guys have liked, commented, and if you guys haven't done any of that, at least hit the subscribe button and make sure that bell is on so you get updated for part two. See you guys.